Hi guys, welcome back to another unboxing video on Game Gods Official. I'm Kiyomi, it's nice to see you again. I know I don't do videos that often, I'm usually the editor, so I like to do behind the scenes stuff. But every so often, something comes in and I really want to shoot a video for it. Just to get a deal, but I'm ballin', ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing, yeah, you know I done it, that is no discussion, bitch, I'm ballin', ballin'. I made a promise to my mama, I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas. We're gonna do a headset unboxing today, and I guess let me give you a brief history of gaming headsets for Connecticut and I. So a long time ago, I think it's been maybe almost 8 years now, we did get our first gaming headsets, and I believe it was the Titans. I don't even remember what model it was. All I remember is that it was a single earphone cup with the headrest here and a pretty decent mic. I believe at the time we actually used them for our PS4s. So those were the first gaming headsets that we ever got. Fast forward to PC gaming and we needed to find a headset that would work on our gaming laptops. And the number one thing that we wanted to make sure was that it also had a very good mic on the headset. So enter Logitech. Now, our first pair, I think it was the G930s, I want to say. Didn't have any RGB because RGB wasn't the thing yet. Had a pretty good mic. And honestly, it actually lasted us for a good little while. As the headsets got older though, we did start running into problems where the USB dongle didn't always sync with it, or sometimes it would just randomly die because, well, it's a rechargeable battery and that happens. So we looked for the next model. Enter the G933s. So that's these ones. These were the ones that we originally got, and they only came in black when they got released, so that was what we got. Now, to be perfectly honest, they have worked pretty well. The ear cups right here are very comfortable, and the headband right here, also very comfortable. It was more of a problem for me wearing them for extended periods of time, just because it felt like the weight of the headset would start digging down on the top of my head, so it could start aching a little bit. The mic and everything on it was really, really good. Our biggest gripe was just that with the RGB light strip, it's right here on the back. I guess you can probably see it right there beside my nails. The mic was great. Audio quality that came through was awesome. So that was these ones. And then I think it was maybe a couple years after these got released, Logitech actually ended up releasing the Artemis Snow. It's the exact same model, just different color, the white that Connecticut actually really, really likes, and that I will admit actually looks really sleek as well. So that's where these ones enter, and Connecticut is actually still using these because, well, they still work. Now, what's the story behind that, you ask? Since the first Logitech headsets that we got, so the G930, like I said, it kind of towards the end of its life started going haywire on us. And in the instance of the G930s, I honestly can't remember what it was except for maybe the starting to get faulty battery. But as far as I remember, the headset itself still worked reasonably well. Now, with these ones, we had actually initially ordered two pairs of the Artemis Snow, so the white ones, to replace this and the G930. These ended up being able to recover partly, and we ended up having to send one pair of the Artemis Snow back to Amazon because one set arrived faulty. So as of right now, we have this one and we have this one. So the problem with this is that since I've been using it in the last few months, I literally have to hit it in order for the audio to actually come through. And when I'm playing on the Xbox, it's really frustrating, to say the least, to sit here and I'll show you. This is what I have to do to make this headset work. I'll put it on and I'll turn the switch on and I'll cross my fingers and actually hope that the headset will work. For instance, right now I can tell that it turned on, but it's really, really quiet. And that's not normally the case. So what do I have to do? Well, at first I would just kind of, you know, wiggle it around a little bit, you know, do a little bit of this, do a little bit of that. If you remember like old school earphones, eventually the jack would kind of just start screwing up. So you'd have to wiggle it around. That was basically what I was doing with a wireless headset. the wiggling around worked a little bit here and there, and then one day it just stopped working. What was my next step? To hit it like this, out of frustration. And lo and behold, it started working. Everybody who was in my Xbox party could hear me. And all of a sudden, when I used it on my computer, I could actually hear the audio at the volume at which I wanted to hear it. So I kind of found a workaround. However, in about the last 2 weeks or so, it's actually gotten quite bad and very inconsistent in how my mic sounds, how it works, and also how the audio sounds and how well it comes through on the headset. So obviously, it was time for a new headset. So I hit the market and I read a bunch of articles and I tried to find out what would be the best headset. I actually had my heart set on the SteelSeries Arctic 9X. They worked with the Xbox, they worked with the PC, and given that I play on the Xbox and the PC, that was really all I needed. Kodenica, though, wanted to try, just in case we ever end up playing on our PlayStations again, wanted to find a headset that would work across the board, much like how these ones do. Because with the Logitechs, you can plug the USB dongle into the PlayStation. And when you're on the Xbox, all you gotta do is take that headphone cord jack that they supply, plug it into the headset, plug it into the controller, and you're good to go. So, as much as I had my heart set on the SteelSeries, in the end, we decided, okay, we can probably find something else. And as much as I did not want to do another Logitech headset for the reasons that I've already mentioned, we ended up getting the Logitech. At first, Kinetica had actually found the Logitech G733 Lightspeeds. Super cute, really colorful headsets, and something that a lot of people were actually very happy about. The mic quality was still okay, audio quality was still great, and what really got a lot of people was two factors, I feel. First, as you can see, Logitech really only has black or white headsets. The G733s, however, had four different colors. They had a white and they had a black, per standard. They also had a lavender and also a light blue. On top of that as well, the RGB light strip was in front. It was on the front of the headset, so people could actually see your RGB lighting. Also, they came with an optional accessory pack that you could purchase for, I think it was like an additional $10. And it was these little like microphone coverings that you could get. And they were super cute things. Like there was a mustache, there was a heart, a star, like a thumbs up. They did really well with that item. But the reason why we ended up not getting that one, as much as I actually did really want to get a color, they were only Bluetooth enabled. So they could have worked with the PS4s and probably the PS5, and they worked with the PC. But like I said, we wanted something that would work across the board with both consoles and our computers. So obviously I couldn't get that one. We ended up settling for the G935, which is the one that I have in front of me right now. And so after that somewhat brief history, let me go ahead and unbox this for you. Ready? Set. Shling! Kunai time. All right. Okay, there's one. And here's the second one. All right, and ta-da! All right, ready. Lower this down. And there they are. Okay. All right, so here's the headset. So I guess this one comes out first. Looks like that's the peripherals. And here's the headset itself. So, oh, I got a laptop sticker. That's cool. I probably won't put that on, but it's a nice little souvenir. Oh, just a little book showing different products that they sell as well, including the RGB speakers that I was interested in at one point. And let me get these peripherals out of here. Oh, I'm almost losing a manual. Looks like this one is the earphone jack, I guess? Yeah, it's a 3.5 millimeter ring, I think. So there you go. All right, we'll put that right there. And then this one is gonna be the USB charging cord. There you go. All right, so let's get this baby out of the packaging. Nice and gentle. There we are. Put that over there. So, straight out of the packaging, looking at it from the back, it looks much the same as basically previous products. The RGB light strip is right here by the buttons. I think I can put presets on these. Not that I ever actually have. Volume dial is right here. And the power button, as always, is here. Headphone jack and the charging port are right here. It looks pretty sleek. I'll compare them for you in just a moment. But this is actually leather. It feels super smooth. It's super nice. And so is the headrest on the headband, I guess. That's also leather. It feels really nice and smooth. Going by the top, they have the Logitech G there. The side panels are a little bit different. I think in the past, you'll see when I compare them, but in the past models, especially the G933s, there's three slashes, kind of like the Adidas slash. All right, so let's pop this open real quick. As you can see, the sticker is telling me that the USB dongle is right here. So that's that. Let me get that out real quick. There we are. Okay. And then I'm gonna take this off and I'll put this back on and over to the other side, which is most likely where the battery is probably gonna be. Yeah, yes, lo and behold, there's the battery. All right, so like I said, I was gonna do a comparison for you, but you know what? I really wanna try putting this on first real quick. This leather looks really smooth and comfy, especially up here where the headband rest is as well. So let's go ahead and put it on. Wow. Okay. I don't know if it's just because it's a brand new headset, so obviously there hasn't been any wear in yet, but the ear cups feel super secure. I like how they block out sound. Like, for instance, right now, my neighbors are talking outside. I can barely hear them. It's really nice. All right. Anyways, like I said, I told you about the mute mic button. There's the second way to do it is to make sure that you have the mic pulled up like this. So instead of having it down, where you can also adjust the length of it as well. So like that, you can push it. I'm going to push it back in and push it back up. And that should also mute the mic as well. Anyways, let's see what the differences on the headsets look like real quick. So, like I said, the ear cups on these are leather. All right, so that's the leather. If we compare these ones, well, forgive the makeup that's on them, but I do wear makeup. These ones here are actually cloth. You can tell kind of by the fabric, especially if you look where my foundation has rubbed off on it, you can see the mesh on it. Nothing wrong with that. They're actually quite comfortable, but the leather feels nice. And the last one, I'm gonna take a quick look. Yeah, same deal with the Artemis Snow. You can't quite tell because there isn't as much makeup. I haven't worn these as much, but the fabric is there. And the lining on the headphone part where like the drivers and stuff are, it is also the same. So across the board. So yeah, there we go. The headrest on the headband, like I said, for the 935s, they are leather. For these ones, like the headphone cups, it is also fabric, but again, also very comfy. Flipping them over, you'll be able to see the difference on the ear cups. So the Logitech G is there in all three spots, but with the 933s, there's the three lines that I told you about, like the Adidas lashes, so one, two, three. Whereas this one has a little zigzag that goes down like this. Super sleek, honestly, I really, really like them. And I'm actually really looking forward to trying these on. Maybe these will treat me a little better than the G933s did, than the G930 did. But I guess, for the most part, that's gonna be it. I'm looking forward to testing the mic quality on these. Hopefully they're as outstanding as the G933s. By all accounts, they should be. Logitech does have that going for it. Their mics, like I said before, and I will say it again, are of outstanding quality. And I've always been happy with the audio quality that I get from them as well. I'm sure if I was a true audiophile, I'd probably be like, oh, they're okay. But honestly, as long as I hear my sound effects and my gunshots when I'm playing Call of Duty or whatever else I choose to play, and they sound nice and crisp to me, I'm a happy girl. All right, so that'll do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it, and make sure you come back and check out some more of our videos. We recently just got some new inline skates, the power slides. We've already posted a couple of videos of those. They're mostly just gonna be vlogs, but they're super fun, and I can't wait to shoot a video for you guys with our new LED light up wheels. They are actually the bomb, okay? So come back soon, and don't forget, hit that like button, hit the share button, make sure you subscribe, and I will see you all very, very soon, okay? Bye! I feel like I'm a giant when I'm 5'8. I feel more defiant when y'all hate. Yeah, the only niggas running in the car race. Serving nigga with a butter like parquet. Rap niggas all soft, so strong, Jay. I'm a little bit of Pac, but a Kanye. You a little bit of Fox and Beyonce. Any beef gonna be, get sauteed. Y'all the fake ones running with a hard face. Bet that pop to your tongue, make your heart race.